Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Welcome to my another tutorial on Android app development. In this video I will show you how to send data from your Android to your laptop and from your laptop to your Android phone. Basically I will be implementing a chat application where you can message from Android to your laptop and from your laptop to Android. Basically I will be using socket programming in this video. So first of all, if you have not already subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel. So let's get started. So first of all, let me assign Android as a client, and I will assign laptop as my server. So I will be using NetBeans Java. So let me first of all create an edit text. Enter your message. Have a button. Send. All right. So basically I will now initialize socket. All right, and I will be requiring edit text. Also I will be requiring, let me assign them to private. Private print writer. Alright, so I will initialize the edit text here as alright. So let me create a method here, send data. So here I will create another class. No, basically I will be creating the class here, class background task extend async task. In here I will write void. Alright, so I need to implement the method do in background. Alright, so what I will do is I will first of all initialize the socket here. Let me delete the private, I don't need the private. Alright, so I will write s equals to new socket. In here I will provide the IP and the port number. So this will be my Android and I want to find the IP of my laptop. So how to find? Let me open command prompt cmd. In here write ip configure. So here you can see 192.168.10.40. 192.168.40 and port number will be 6000. Alright, so this is I am having an error IO exception, so I will write now the error is gone. The next step is I have to initialize the print writer. So I will write writer equals to new print writer. In here I will provide s dot get output stream. We need an output stream to send the data. So I will write, now I want to send the message. So for that, let me here initialize string message equals to e1 dot get text dot to string. All right, now I want to send the message to this background class. basically, so how can I send this string? So I will call the class background class b1 equals to new background class b1 dot execute, and in here I have to write message. All right, I want to send a message. So here, how can I receive this by string? I think the last method is string. No, all right. Now in here I need to write string message equals to voids 0. All right, so I will write writer dot write. In here what I will write is message. Now I will need to flush the writer, need to close it, and or we will close the socket. All right, let me not close the socket here. So this our class Android work is complete. So now I need to work on, basically let me say on click method, send data. And in Android manifest file we have internet and read external storage. All right, so it is complete. Now I need to receive the data. So where I can receive the data, I will write NetBeans. I will open my NetBeans. So here I will create a new project, new Java application, my server Java. Okay, this is showing me error because of this one, so I will just delete, close the project here, my Java app, close it also, Java app, close it also. I will create another project, Java application 4. Alright, so here in source new JFrame form, my server frame. Now I click on finish. In here what I will do is I will just paste. I want to drag text area. Here we will receive the data. All right, so here what we will do is first of all we will initialize our socket. And we will initialize server socket. Also we need an input stream reader. And I will also require a buffer reader. All right, now in here our main method, what we need to do is we need to write s equals to new, sorry, first of all we will initialize the server socket. So here we will provide the port number. So I will specify 5000 because in our Android application 6000, sorry, it will connect with 6000. Now it is showing me an error because no static variable cannot be referenced from a static. So I will need to write static socket static and also. Alright, now it is giving me an IO exception. I will write IO exception. E dot print stack trace. Alright, now I will initialize the socket here. Socket equals to ss dot accept, server socket dot accept. Alright, now I will initialize the input stream reader to read the image. New input stream reader, and in here I will provide s dot get input stream. Now I need to read it, the input stream reader, so you are using buffer reader. New buffer reader, and I will provide the input stream reader here. Alright, now let me initialize another static stream message. So I will write message equals to br.readline. Now I want to print the message, so I will just write system.out.println message. Alright, and I need to write j text area 1 dot set text, and I will, now it is giving me error, so I need to make it static. Go to code and in here make it static. Alright, is it still giving me an error? Why is it still giving me an error? No, it's alright. Alright, now when I run it, run file. So as you guys can see, this is running. Now I am missing a thing here. I need to while true, this one. So I will save it. Now I go to my Android. Now let me connect my Android phone. Let's see if we can receive the message. So I need to open MirrorGo. Let's see if it works or not. So we need to run this file, our Android is running, so I will just write run. Let's see if it works. I hope it works. So it's running. Let me show you the output. So here I will write Hello, and when I click on send, as you guys can see, hello is printed. Now if I write hi and I click on send, as you guys can see, this is changed. Now I want to print this one inside, so I will append it. So how to append it? Let me close it because ignore. So how to do it? Go to your Android Java file. Java file. Now here if we will check if jtextarea1.getText.toString.equals empty. If it is empty, what to do? Print it, all right. Else jtextarea1.setText. Now here what we will do is we will write Android plus jtextarea1.getText plus line and plus jtextarea1.getText. Alright, so now let's run. I will write run file. Now we will write hello. All right. Now we write how are you? It is not okay. I made a mistake here. So what is the mistake? So we will write plus extra line and plus message. All right, so now let me run it. Now you guys can see we write how are you. I will write I am fine. Goodbye. Alright, so if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Goodbye.